the day science begins to study non-physical phenomena, it will make more progress in one decade than in all the previous centuries of its existence. My brain is only a receiver. In the universe, there is a core from which we obtain knowledge, strength, and inspiration. If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. I don't care that they stole my idea. I care that they don't have any of their own. Every living being is an engine geared to the wheelwork of the universe. We crave for new sensations, but soon become indifferent to them. The wonders of yesterday are today common occurrences. The present is theirs, the future, for which I really worked, is mine. The progressive development of man is vitally dependent on invention. It is the most important product of his creative brain. The spread of civilization may be likened to a fire, first, a feeble spark, next a flickering flame, then a mighty blaze, ever increasing in speed and power. The scientists of today think deeply instead of clearly. One must be sane to think clearly, but one can think deeply and be quite insane. I do not think there is any thrill that can go through the human heart like that felt by the inventor, as he sees some creation of the brain unfolding to success. Of all things, I like books best. All that was great in the past was ridiculed, condemned, combated, suppressed, only to emerge all the more powerfully, all the more triumphantly from the struggle. Invention is the most important product of man's creative brain. The ultimate purpose is the complete mastery of mind over the material world, the harnessing of human nature to human needs. Instinct is something which transcends knowledge. We have, undoubtedly, certain finer fibers that enable us to perceive truths when logical deduction, or any other willful effort of the brain, is futile. Our virtues and our failings are inseparable, like force and matter. When they separate, man is no more. If your hate could be turned into electricity, it would light up the whole world. Peace can only come as a natural consequence of universal enlightenment and merging of races, and we are still far from this blissful realization. It is paradoxical, yet true, to say that the more we know, the more ignorant we become in the absolute sense, for it is only through enlightenment that we become conscious of our limitations. In the 21st century, the robot will take the place which slave labor occupied in ancient civilization. The individual is ephemeral, races and nations come and pass away, but man remains. The history of science shows that theories are perishable. With every new truth that is revealed, we get a better understanding of nature and our conceptions and views are modified. Our senses enable us to perceive only a minute portion of the outside world. Today's scientists have substituted mathematics for experiments, and they wander off through equation after equation, and eventually build a structure which has no relation to reality. It is a simple feat of scientific electrical engineering, only expensive, blind, faint-hearted, doubting world. There is no conflict between the ideal of religion and the ideal of science, but science is opposed to theological dogmas because science is founded on fact. Great moments are born great opportunity. We are all one. People are interconnected by invisible forces. Let the future tell the truth and evaluate each one according to his work and accomplishments. The present is theirs, the future, for which I have really worked, is mine. The gift of mental power comes from God, divine being, and if we concentrate our minds on that truth, we become in tune with this great power. You may live to see man-made horrors beyond your comprehension. It is not in the shallow physical imitation of men that women will assert first their equality and later their superiority, but in the awakening of the intellect of women. I do not think you can name many great inventions that have been made by married men. In the realm of science, all attempts to find any evidence of supernatural beings, of metaphysical conceptions, as God, immortality, infinity, etc. have thus far failed, and if we are honest, we must confess that in science there exists no God, no immortality, no soul or mind as distinct from the body. Life is and will ever remain an equation incapable of solution, but it contains certain known factors.